Hello dear students, welcome to physics class. Myself Shweta Kulkarni from JSS RSH PU College Vidyagiri Dharwad, Department of Physics. It is a continuation part of the chapter Nuclei part 3. In the last class we discussed about the radioactivity, properties of the alpha, beta and gamma radiation. Before that, mass defect, binding energy and binding energy curve. That binding energy curve is an important concept and a few points about that binding energy curve. Later we discuss about the radioactivity, alpha, beta, gamma radiations and properties of alpha, beta and gamma radiation. In this session we discuss about the laws of radioactivity, half lifetime, mean lifetime, then a nuclear energy, nuclear fission and a nuclear fusion. Discussed points are laws of radioactivity, lifetime of radioactive element, half lifetime, mean lifetime, nuclear energy and a nuclear fusion. ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಅರೈಸ್ ಆಗ್ಬೋದು, ರೇಡಿಯೋ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಮತ್ತು ಲೈಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಈಗ ಡಿಲಿಟೆಡ್ ಆಗೈತೆ ಅಂದರೂ ಹೇಳಿಕತ್ತಿರಲ್ಲ ಅಂಥೇಳಿ. ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್ ಇಯರ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಪೇಪರ್ ನಾವು ರೆಫರ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ರೇಡಿಯೋ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ನಿಮ್ದು ಲೈಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಡೆರಿವೇಷನ್ ಆಗಲಿ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಆಗಲಿ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್ ಹೇಳಿದರೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಅದು ಹೆಂಗೆ ಬಂತು ಅನ್ನೋ ಐಡಿಯಾ ಬರೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂಥೇಳಿ, ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಇದು ಡಿಲೀಟ್ ಆದರೂ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಲಿ ಅಂಥೇಳಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕತ್ತದ. ರೇಡಿಯೋ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಮೇಲೆ ಮತ್ತು ಅದರದ ಲೈಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ರೆ ಇದರ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮೆಟಿಕ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ಡೆರಿವೇಷನ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಇರ್ತಿತ್ತು. ಬಟ್ ಇವಾಗ ಅದು ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ತೆಗ್ದಿರೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಅದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಕೇಳ್ಬೋದು, ಕೇಳಲಿಕ್ಕಿಲ್ಲ. ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಡಿಲಿಟೆಡ್ ಆಗೈತಂದ್ರೆ ಆ ಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಮೇಲೆ ನಿಮ್ದು ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್ ಬರೋಂಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಇಫ್ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ದೇ ಆಸ್ಕ್, ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಅದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಒಂದು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಆದರೂ ಐಡಿಯಾ ಇರಲಿ ಅನ್ನೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಡಿಲಿಟೆಡ್ ಆಗಿದ್ರು ಆ ಪೋರ್ಷನನ್ನು ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಒಂದ್ಸಲ ರಿವೈಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕದು. ಓಕೆ, ಮೂಟು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ಲಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರೇಡಿಯೋ ಆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಡಿಕೆ. ವಾಟ್ ದ ಲಾ ಇಟ್ ಸೇಸ್? ದ ರೇಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿಸ್ಇಂಟಿಗ್ರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ರೇಡಿಯೋ ಆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಎಟ್ ಆನ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನಲ್ ಟು ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಾ ಇನ್ ದ ರೇಡಿಯೋ ಆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಎಟ್ ದಟ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಒಂದು ನಾವು ರೇಡಿಯೋ ಆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ತಗೊಂಡ್ವಿ, ಅದರೊಳಗೆ ಡಿಕೆ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಆಗಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಯಿತು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಒಂದು ಸರ್ಟೇನ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಆದಮೇಲೆ ಅದರೊಳಗೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಾಯಿ ಉಳಿದ್ವು ಅನ್ನೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಅದು ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನಲ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ರೇಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿಸ್ಇಂಟಿಗ್ರೇಷನ್. ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಐ ಆಮ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಒನ್ ರೇಡಿಯೋ ಆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್. ಇಟ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ದ ರೇಡಿಯೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಅ ಟೈಮ್ ಟಿ. ಇಟ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್, ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ reduced. When it reduces for a time interval of t, then a disintegration dn by dt, rate of disintegration is proportional to number of the nuclei present at that time. ಅಂದರೆ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ನನ್ನ ಕಡೆ ಒಂದು 100 ಗ್ರಾಮ್ದು ಒಂದು ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಐತೆ ಅಂತ ಇಟ್ಕೊರಿ. ಅದು ಒಂದು 50 ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ಒಂದು 15 ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲ 1 ಅವರ್ ಆದಮೇಲೆ ಡಿಕೆ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಆಗಿ ಆಗಿ ಏನಾಯ್ತು 80 ಗ್ರಾಮಿಗೆ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆತ ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಕೋರಿ. ಅಂದ್ರೆ 80 ಗ್ರಾಮ್ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗೈತೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ 20% ಅದ್ರೊಳಗೆ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಗೈತೆ ಅಂದಂಗಾತು. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ದ ಲಾ ಇಟ್ ಸೇಸ್, ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಅ ಟೈಮ್ ಇಂಟರ್ವಲ್ ರೇಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿಸ್ಇಂಟಿಗ್ರೇಷನ್, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಡಿಸ್ಇಂಟಿಗ್ರೇಷನ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದು ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನಲ್, ಯಾವ್ದಕ್ಕೆ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನಲ್ ಅದ, ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಾಯ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್. 1 ಅವರ್ ಆದಮೇಲೆ 100 ಇದ್ದಿದ್ದು 80%ಗೆ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗೈತಂತಂದ್ರೆ ರೇಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿಸ್ಇಂಟಿಗ್ರೇಷನ್ ಅದು 80%ಗೆ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನಲ್ ಐತಿ ಅಂದಂಗ. ಸೊ ದ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೇಸ್ ರೇಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿಸ್ಇಂಟಿಗ್ರೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನಲ್ ಟು ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಾಯ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ರೇಡಿಯೋ ಆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಎಟ್ ದಟ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್. ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವೆನ್ ಐ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಅ ಒನ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಅ ಟೈಮ್ ಸರ್ಟೇನ್ ಟೈಮ್ ದ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸರ್ಸ್, ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಡಿಕೆ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್. ದಿಸ್ ಡಿಕೇಡ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ರೇಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿಕೆ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನಲ್ ಟು ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಾಯ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಅಟ್ ದಟ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್. 100 ಇದ್ದಿದ್ದು 80 ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗಿತ್ತಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಅದು ರೇಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿಕೆ ಅದು 80% ಎಷ್ಟು ಉಳಿದಿರ್ತಾವಲ್ಲ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ proportional irutha, means directly proportional. On the base of this law, certain points are to be the inventor. The first point, what it says, this radioactive decay is the spontaneous process. It is not affected by any external condition. As we already discussed, radioactivity is the spontaneous process, means it is not depend upon any other external condition. For example, by increasing the temperature, the process is to be increases? No. By increasing the pressure, the radioactive decay is moving too faster? No. So, it indicates if any changes are to be takes place externally, it is not affect the process of your the radioactivity. Now, temperature, pressure, any physical condition, external condition vary madodrinda, radioactive decay process fast madodagli, slow madodagli sadhyavilla. So, it indicates it is an instantaneous, spontaneous process. Tanninda tan agonta process agirutta. The second point, what it says, at a time, nucleus will emit one alpha or beta, but not emit both at a time. Andhra, if I consider one substance, either it emit alpha or it emit a beta. It could not emit both alpha and beta at a time. One the substance tagondvi antandra, one the alpha particles nadru emit madbeku, illa beta particle nadru emit madbeku, one the time olaga alpha matta beta erdu particle na emit madoka sadhyavilla. Because alpha is a positive, beta is a negative, at a time it could not emit both alpha and beta together. Either it may happen along with the alpha and beta, it may emit the gamma particles, because gamma is the chargeless, means it does not have any sign. Along with the alpha, it emits the gamma. There is no changes in their product form. Along with the beta, if emits the gamma, there is no changes in the product form. So, there is a chance, there may be a chance of emission of alpha with gamma, beta with gamma. But it is not possible alpha and beta together, either alpha or beta. It could not emit both alpha and beta together. It is the second condition. Next, the third condition, what it says? When a radioactive element emits an alpha particle, the position of the daughter element is shifted down. When the radioactive substance alpha particle emit madadaga, baruvantaha product form, daughter element enagutta, periodic table olaga one position kelag hogutta. If an radioactive element emits the alpha particle, then the product, means daughter nuclei position, is shifted down in the periodic table. If it is emit the beta particle, then position of the product, means the position of the daughter nuclei, is raised by one place in the periodic table. When the radioactive element beta particles na emit maaditu antandra, adara the product form olaga baruva daughter nuclei, daughter element the position periodic table olaga one place upper shift agutta. Point is clear. If emits the alpha, shifted down. If emits the beta, then one place is to be raised in the periodic table. Fourth condition. If it emits the gamma particle, there is no changes in their position. It should be remains the same. No, it is a known thing, because gamma, it is the chargeless, either not to be positive or not to be negative. If emits the gamma radiation, then there is no changes in their product form. It is to be remain same as that of the reactant. So, if emits the gamma particle, no changes in their position of the periodic table. Hope you clear the point. Laws of radioactive decay. The law, it says, rate of disintegration is directly proportional to number of the nuclei present at that time. Radioactive decay process aagtittu antandre adarda rate of disintegration directly proportional irutha yavudukkantandre eshtu nuclei aa time olaga ulidirtavu adar mele. The condition radioactivity is a spontaneous process. It is not depends upon any other external or physical condition. Second one, the nuclei either emit alpha or beta. It is not possible to emit both alpha and beta together. Third one, if the element produces the alpha particle, its product for element position is shifted down in the periodic table. If it emits the beta particle, its position is raised by one place in the periodic table. Fourth one, if it emits the gamma, then there is no changes in the position in the periodic table. It should be remains in that position only. Now, on the base of this law only, you have the derivation of the lifetime of the element. ಇದು ನಿಮಗೆ NCERT ಬೋರ್ಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನೇಷನ್ಗೆ ಇದು ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಇಲ್ಲದೇ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಬಟ್ ನಿಮ್ದು ಕಾಂಪಿಟೇಟಿವ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನೀಟ್ CET ಗೆ ಏನಾದರೂ ಇದ್ರ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಆಗಲಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಇದು ಇಕ್ವೇಶನ್ದ ಡೆರಿವೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕದ. ದ ಡೆರಿವೇಷನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೇಸ್ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ರೇಡಿಯೋ ಆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಡಿಕೇ ಲಾ, ದೇ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ radioactive substance having n0 number of the atom before decay. Andra one substance olaga initially n0 number of the nuclei irutav. When a substance disintegrate means when a decay process start, the number of atom decreases to n means number of the nuclei reduces to n after a time interval t. Andra initially n0 number of the nuclei irtavu, time t admele it reduces to n number of the nuclei. Initial before decay n0 number of the nuclei, after certain time decay process start, then reduces to n number of the nuclei. Before decay initial number of the nuclei are n0, after decay number of the nuclei reduces to n. Atom decrease agate antandre nuclei value nu decrease agate. If dn number of the atom decayed means decreases at the interval of time dt, then the rate of disintegration heng baritara dn by dt rate anna r anthe indicate madidare with the negative sign. Why this a negative sign? Here this negative sign indicate decreases in the number atom number n. Andra substance hechgi ittu, time adukule substance reduce agetu antandre decrease agetu, decrease agirodakke enattu nimage rate of disintegration value negative anta torisidru. As the disintegration increases, amount of reducers is also increases, so negative value go on increases. Andra one substance namage 100% ittu, disintegration speed akont hodanga reduce akont barudu speed aatu, reduce agetantandra value decrease aatu, andra negative value enatu increase aatu. Clear the point? Dn number of the nuclei with the time dt, then the rate of disintegration dn by dt rate an r anth mention madidru with the negative sign. Negative sign akantandra time increase akont hodanga dn by dt process increase aatu, reduce akont barodu increase aatu. Reduce agetantandra mass value nuclei value kadimi agirodakke negative sign mention madidara. Clear the point how the expression they are written. Next point, according to the law what it says, rate of disintegration dn by dt is proportional to number of the nuclei present at that point. Number of the nuclei present at that point. Number of the nuclei antandre n number of the nuclei are present. Rate of disintegration dn by dt. Kadme agiradakke negative sign. Directly proportional. Though according to the statement, rate of disintegration dn by dt directly proportional to which quantity? Number of the nuclei present. Andre rate yest nuclei present annodr male directly proportional ad. Next thing, here dn by dt can be replaced by r, rate of disintegration. So they taken r equal to dn by dt, r equals to dn by dt. Then to remove the proportionality constant, they introduce the term lambda. Then the lambda, they named it as an decay constant. Dn by dt directly proportional to another. A proportionality constant tegibek ant heli, sorry, proportionality tegibek ant heli constant introduce madidru, a constant ge decay constant ant heli naming madidru. Then this can also be written as a dn by dt and negative sign more in the right hand side. Dn by dt equal to minus of lambda dt. Then they arrange the term n and n one side, so dn by n and this dt term is a cross multiplied, n by n and t term to in this form. So it is a dn by n at one side and a time quantity at the another side. Proportionality constant tagiyodakke lambda introduce madidru as a decay constant. N quantity na one side baribek anta heli dn by n madidru, dt ikade cross multiply madidru. Next step, integrate on the both side. Then apply the integration dn by n. Lambda is the constant quantity, we cannot integrate, is only variable quantity is n. We have the formula, integration of dx by x can be written as a log of x in the exponential form to the base e. Same, integration of dt is only t. Similarly, integration of dx by x can be written as a log of x. Integration of dx by x can be written as a log of x to the base e. Similarly, integration of dn by n can be written as log of n to the base e. Next, integration of dx is x. Similarly, integration of dt is n plus k as the integration constant. Next, time. When the time t equal to 0, integration of dn by n as a log n to the base e, integration of dt is a t and proportionality constant k. Now apply the first condition, before decay at a time t equal to 0, n will be equals to ni. Under n naught is the initial number of the nuclei. Eno decay start agiddilla antandre number of nuclei is equivalent to n naught. Under before n naught irtam. So substitute the value. If t equal to 0, n equal to n naught, then k will be equivalent to log of n naught to the base e. Clear the point. Time t equal to 0 hakidri antandre, ille t equal to 0 hakidri andre n is replaced by n naught antandre, then k value will be equivalent to log of n naught. Then substitute the value. Substitute that value. K value iddale log of n naught substitute madri, log of n to the base e as it is, lambda t as it is, in place of the k, log of n naught to the base e. Then shift the term, log n minus of n naught minus lambda t. Here it is in the form of log a minus log b can be written as log of a by b. Same, log of a by b, it can be written as log of n divided by n naught to the base e, and at the left hand side minus lambda t as it is. only if I know the value of n by n naught, this log e is converted in terms of the exponential form. To the base e etla, adha exponential form agi convert agat. Then rearrange the term n equal to n naught e raised to minus lambda t. This derivation ee time nimga kelangilla ekadra portion na deleted agedda but last to last year ella en martiddu ida base mele nimaga problems kelthidru andre question 5 mark question nu kelthidru for that reason I am revising this one also the derivation part but you should remember this final expression this expression is helpful in your the competitive examination also move to next one here that lambda indicates the radioactive decay constant the definition of a radioactive decay constant what it says it is a reciprocal of the time during the number of atom in the radioactive substance reduces to 36.9% of the original number of the atom andra lambda antandre en madidru reciprocal of the time ಒಂದು ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟನ್ಸ್ ಅದ 36.9% ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗಕ್ಕೆ ಏನ ಟೈಮ್ ಬೇಕಲ್ಲ ಅದರದ ರೆಸಿಪ್ರೋಕಲ್ ಕ್ವಾಂಟಿಟಿಗೆ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡಾ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ನೇಮಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ದ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೇಸ್ ರೆಸಿಪ್ರೋಕಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್ ಫಾರ್ ವಿಚ್ ದ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟನ್ಸ್ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ಟು 36% ಆಫ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಒರಿಜಿನಲ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಇಟ್ ಇಂಡಿಕೇಟ್ಸ್ ರೇಡಿಯೋ ಆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಡಿಕೇ constant on the base of this radioactive decay constant we can determine the rate of a radioactive decay if a lambda value is more it indicates the decay process is to be very faster if the lambda value is less then the decay process is slower on the base of the lambda we can determine the fastness of the radioactive decay process lambda is more process is to be very fast lambda is less then the process is to be slow down another one half lifetime of a radioactive substance usually lifetime antandre navu helthivu nam lifetime anand 70 years 80 years ing antare illi half lifetime antandre one substance ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಅರ್ಧ ಆಗೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಟೈಮಿಂಗ್ ತಗೊಂತೈತ್ಲ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಹಾಫ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಅಂತೀರಿ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ 100 ಗ್ರಾಮ್ದ ನಾವೊಂದು ರೇಡಿಯೋ ಆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಇತ್ತು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅದು 50 ಗ್ರಾಮ್ ತನ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನು ಟೈಮಿಂಗ್ ಬೇಕಾಗ್ಲ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಹಾಫ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಆಫ್ ರೇಡಿಯೋ ಆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ದ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೇಸ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ವಿಚ್ ಹಾಫ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಟಮ್ ಆಫ್ ರೇಡಿಯೋ ಆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ disintegrate is called half lifetime of that substance means if it is 100% then disintegrate to 50% then the time requirement is called half lifetime idr the derivation madila direct nimge expression ada ಈ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್ ಬೇಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ 2 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಇಲ್ಲ 3 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಕೇಳ್ಬೋದು ಲ್ಯಾಂಡಾ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಕೊಟ್ಟು ಹಾಫ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಮಾಡಿರಿ ಹಿಂಗೇನಾದರೂ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಈ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಟಿ ಹಾಫ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 0.6931 ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡಾ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೀನ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಆರ್ ಆವರೇಜ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಮೀನ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ರೇಡಿಯೋ ಆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ sum of the total lifetime of all divided by total number of the atom present if it has 3 number of the atom then sum of lifetime of all the 3 divided by 3 average tagitivala same thing so it is a t total lifetime of all the number divided by number of the nuclei it indicates mean lifetime ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಒನ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಈ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ನಿಮ್ದು ಡಿಲಿಟೆಡ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ ಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಒಳಗೆ ನಿಮ್ದು ಲೈಫ್ ಟೈಮು ಮೀನ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಟೈಮು ಹಾಫ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಟೈಮು ಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಡಿಲಿಟೆಡ್ ಆಗದ ಬಟ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ನಿಮ್ದು ರಿಟೈನ್ಡ್ ಅದ ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಕ್ಯೂ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆರ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಆಫ್ ಅ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ವಾಟ್ ದೇ ಇಟ್ ಸೇಸ್ The energy absorbed or released during nuclear reaction is known as Q value. If any reaction is going on, like for example, nuclear bomb or formation of the sun or formation of the star, in that nuclear reaction, some amount of the energy is absorbed for the reaction and some amount of the energy is released after the reaction. Such a type of the energy is known as Q value or energy of a nuclear reaction. On the base of this Q value, they divided the nuclear reaction into two types. One is endothermic, another one is exothermic. The endothermic, what it says, the mass of the product of a nuclear reaction is greater than mass of the reactant. If these two are the product and one nuclear reaction is takes place and produces some reactant. Here mass of this product is greater than the mass of the reactant. Such reactions are known as endothermic. Product the mass greater iddu reactant mass kadmi ittantandra adakke endothermic reaction antiri. In that Q value is negative, means it absorb or release less amount of the energy. Next one is exothermic. Mass of the reactant is greater than mass of the product. Idu nimde product nuclear reaction agi reactant aatu antandra reactant mass greater ittu product mass kadmi ittu antandra then the reaction is known as exothermic. In this Q value is positive, means it absorb or produce more amount of the energy. Clear the point? Nuclear energy or Q value. Another one is important concept, nuclear energy or Q value, both are of the same. Energy released during nuclear reaction, either a fission or fusion reaction, is known as nuclear energy. First one is fission. Fission means splitting up of. Why this nuclear fusion and fission takes place? Already discussed. Because fission means heavier particle split up into lighter. Heavier means the elements are to be unstable. To get the stability, it is split up into lighter particle. Nuclear fusion. Fusion means combining. Lighter particle also unstable. Means this nuclear fission and fusion process takes place because the unstable elements are to be getted as an stable element. To get the stability, the unstable elements moves under the process of nuclear fission or nuclear fusion. Nuclear fission fusion yakagutantandra unstable iro elements stable ago sambandha nuclear fission matta fusion process olaga barutta. Then the fission it says it is a process of splitting a heavy nucleus into two lighter nuclei along with the release of a amount of the energy. Means heavier element split up into two lighter element along with the release of the energy. Such a reaction is known as fission. Example they are given. Uranium-235 is interact with the neutron become uranium-236. Then this heavier one split up into two lighter particle. Same uranium is split up into barium and krypton along with the three neutron and energy. Heavier one become two lighter particle along with the energy, then it is known as nuclear fission. Means heavier one split up into lighter particle. In this nuclear fission, again we have the two type. One is a controlled chain reaction, another one is uncontrolled chain reaction. Means heavier split up into two lighter. Again the splitting process is takes place. If this chain process is a controlled manner, then it is known as a controlled chain reaction. They stated as if more than one neutron produced in the fission reaction causes further fission at each stage, then the number of the fission and energy released multiplied rapidly. Such a reaction is called uncontrolled chain reaction. What is the meaning of that one? Andra, ille if particle split up agbekandre first enu idakke neutron inda interaction agbek. Heavier particle neutron jothe interact agi two lighter particle bartavu idr jothege en martati matte neutron ana produce madut. Ille consider madid three neutron ana produce madut more than one. ತ್ರೀ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಾನ್ ಬಂದು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಇವು ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಾನ್ ಮತ್ತು ಇದ್ರ ಜೊತೆ ಇಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ತಾವ. ಅಗೇನ್ ದ ಸ್ಪ್ಲಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್. ಮತ್ತು ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಾನ್ ಲೈಟರ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಜೊತೆ ಇಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಮತ್ತು ಸ್ಪ್ಲಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಮತ್ತು ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಾನ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ದ ಸ್ಪ್ಲಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇಫ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ದನ್ ಒನ್ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಾನ್ ದೆನ್ ದ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಅನ್ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲೇಬಲ್. ಸಚ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ನೋನ್ ಆಸ್ uncontrolled chain reaction. In the controlled, heavier split up into two lighter, if it produce only one neutron, then the reaction is to be in the controlled form. Vanda ittu antandre vanda idara split agutha illa idara split agutha eradu agangilla. In case more than one ittu antandre idu eradu splitting agi uncontrolled manner agutha. Vanda nuclei produce itandre idu vanda process. Means if it produces only one neutron, then the reaction is in the controlled form. If it produces more than one, then it is in the uncontrolled form. So it is uncontrolled chain reaction and controlled chain reaction. Next point is nuclear fusion. Fusion means combining, a process in which two lighter nuclei combine to form a nucleus with a large mass number along with a simultaneous release of a large amount of energy is called nuclear fusion. Andra, two lighter particle combine to form a heavier one with a large mass number also produces a large amount of the energy. Example is here two deuterium combine to form a helium along with the energy. Best example antandre nimde sun. Sun inda namge enagirutha huge amount of the energy irutha. Inside the sun, which type of the reaction? Formation of the star. Again the process is the same. Deuterium combine to form the helium, again helium combine to form the tritium. Means when this lighter particles are combining, it produces very large amount of the energy comparing to your the fission process. Nuclear bomb namga agutha heavier one ididu split up agi lighter agi, but compared to that we get the more amount of the energy inside the sun, right? So on the base of this we came to know that nuclear fusion produces more amount of the energy compared to the nuclear fission. So the differences, we just glance through it. Fission, first write the definition on both side. Then fission is endothermic. Okay, fission means heavier split up into lighter. Heavier means product mass is greater than the reactant. Fission, lighter to form a heavier. At the product mass is less, so it is the exothermic. Fission is a Q value is a negative. It produces a less amount of the energy. Fusion, it produces a large amount of the energy. So next statement, it releases a less energy compared to the fusion. Andra nimde nuclear bomb helidvi, nuclear bomb olaga split up agudath. But formation of the star olaga hechgi energy irodakka it reduces more amount of the energy. requirement of the energy is also less. Here requirement of energy is also more. Example, nuclear bomb and fusion of the star. Hope you clear the point. Fission and fusion, ee concept nimge deleted agilla, retained ada. They may ask the 3-mark question on the base of this one. Write the difference between nuclear fission and fusion. If they ask, you can write any 3 differences between fission and the fusion. Thank you. In the next class, we discuss the last concept, nuclear reactor, and also we discuss question asked in the previous year examination. ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಇಯರ್ ಒಳಗೆಲ್ಲ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್ ಕೇಳಿರೋ ಸಂಬಂಧ ಅದನ್ನು ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಮಾಡೋಣ. ಹೈಯರ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಸ್ಗೆ ಅದು ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಆಗೋ ಸಂಬಂಧ ಅದನ್ನು ಒಮ್ಮೆ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಮಾಡೋಣ. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು.